artificial intelligence paired with a wearable smart device like this can finally predict the future. You could find out if you're gonna be sick before you show any symptoms. This remarkable technology is real, and I'm gonna show you how it works. Welcome to Neon Future Science. So what exactly is this new tech? And how does a glimpse into the future help mankind today? I spoke to Dr. Rezai, head of the Rockefeller Neuroscience Institute, to learn more about it.
Historically, in medicine and health, when you get sick, you go to the hospital at a point of failure or crisis. But for the first time, we have a window into the nervous system that we can measure elements of it as it's governing your life and day-to-day function. Using watch technology, a ring technology, wristband technology, artificial intelligence, AI, machine learning, we can continuously in real time measure the human operating system. An example we're doing this in athletes and military, so we can see those who are super high performers, before the performance, they're calmer because that means that your body is rested and balanced most.
I have my own statement of that because when I do a big show, people like think that you're a DJ, you're like partying all day before the big show. I'm not doing anything. I am calm. And then I give 100%.
Monitoring our health lets scientists see how we function in real time, opening the door to optimize our bodies for the future. But don't take my word for it. Listen to Dr. Rezai.
So you have 8 sensors, Steve. These 8 sensors, we're able to measure it constantly using our gaming technology. So you play a game in an app for 5 minutes and we know what's going on for your fatigue, or if you're more impulsive, or if you're more irritable, we can detect that. All together gives us an element of the human operating system.
Just by using this app and playing simple games, I'm teaching the AI to understand what's going on inside my body. Then this data can be used to optimize my performance. I always knew video games were good for me.
We use our COVID app, for example. In the morning when you wake up, we ask, how's your sense of smell? Are you having headaches? Are you having fevers? We're able to predict using this technology early on those who have increased cravings from addiction. If you have somebody with Alzheimer's, dementia, or aging, we ask aging and memory-related questions. They're specific for what we're studying. At the same time, the data from your entire human operating system is going up in the cloud, and we're measuring it all together in an AI backbone that's allowing us to predict your state of function, lack of function, resilience, recovery, or chronic disease. You're tapping into the human computer. And if you know how you're doing, then you're empowered as an individual to take charge of your body and make it function the best.
Wow, so my phone will be able to warn me I'm getting sick before I become infectious, helping me seek immediate treatment and preventing me getting anyone else sick. Unreal.
If you're able to synchronize your ring for 3 days, and if you do the gaming 50% of times for 3 days, we will give you a score. So we're able to predict with 82% accuracy that in 3 days from now, you're going to have symptoms of viral illness.
This is science fiction, where science fiction becomes science fact. This is what I want to share with people right here, that with this app, you can detect with an 82% accuracy what your body temp will be in 3 days from now. That is humongous.
Your body, if you're in the red, you have a high chance of developing viral symptoms in the next 3 days.
Can we show mine right now?
Yeah, here's yours. You can see here that we have it back. You can look at it.
I'm looking pretty good, Doc.
Good. Yeah, you're green.
I feel pretty good right now.
The goal is to empower people to be more in charge of their bodies. If you're more in the know about what's going on behind the scenes of your body, you can intervene earlier before your body gets stress the point that it's going to cause disease or damage or chronic conditions.
Okay.
So this is critical for improving human health and humanity. And that's the mission of the Rockefeller Institute, to improve humanity.
Better understanding how our bodies and brains function is critical for the future of humanity. And that's why I started the Aoki Foundation. Our primary goal is to support research that helps preserve our most precious technology of all. Thanks for watching, and thanks, Dr. Rezai, for the fascinating insight.